Thanks so much for joining us for CBN News Midday. I'm Ephraim Graham. A billboard against abortion has sparked a legal battle over free speech and right to privacy. A New Mexico man posted the ad accusing his former girlfriend of having an abortion against his wishes. That woman's friend now says she had a miscarriage and not an abortion. Here's George Thomas.
Take a drive along White Sands Boulevard in Alamogordo, New Mexico, and you're sure to spot this billboard. Greg Fultz holding the outline of an infant in his arms and the words, "This would have been a picture of my two-month-old baby if the mother had decided not to kill our child."
I thought, this would make a pretty good billboard. You know, it's a powerful statement.
The 35-year-old college student says his ex-girlfriend aborted their child.
I wanted to get out this message because I felt that it was important and powerful enough to maybe sway one person's mind from having an abortion.
Fultz's former girlfriend says the message is not true. She's taken him to court for harassment and violation of privacy, and a domestic court official has recommended the billboard be removed. New Mexico Right to Life actually endorsed Fultz's ad, but its members are now having second thoughts.
Well, we contacted Greg and asked to have our endorsement removed from the billboard.
The organization is worried Fultz's girlfriend may have suffered a miscarriage and not had an abortion. George Thomas, CBN News.
Nearly 22% of abortions in the U.S. are performed on Latino women. But another new billboard is launching in Los Angeles to highlight the issue. The sign reads, "The most dangerous place for a Latino is in the womb." It is taking aim at the abortion industry, accusing it of targeting Latino women.
Abortion is a big business. Organizations like Planned Parenthood make a lot of money from abortions. And they're clearly targeting our community, the Latino community. They have clinics throughout the country in Latino communities, barrios, and that's really the reason why the rates are so high.
It's estimated nearly 2.5 million people will see the new billboard campaign. In Illinois, a Catholic adoption agency is suing the state. At issue, a new law that requires adoption agencies to place children with gay couples. Catholic Charity says doing so violates their faith. It wants to continue its practice of referring gay couples to other agencies, something it's done for years. Three Catholic dioceses in Illinois have stopped taking new cases until the issue is resolved. Gay rights advocates say Catholic Charities must follow the law because taxpayer money pays for its adoption and foster care services. Traditional marriage supporters have handily defeated gay marriage this year in Maryland and Rhode Island. But in New York, there is a fierce new campaign underway to legalize gay marriage, and it's backed by two of the state's most powerful politicians. Heather Sells has that story.
Yes, we are gay and we are straight, but we are one state because we are New York.
New York's Governor Andrew Cuomo strongly supported gay marriage in his campaign. And this year, he's assembled an A team of political strategists in Albany to fight for it. His powerful teammate, New York City Mayor Michael Bloomberg, is also hard at work lobbying GOP fence sitters in the state Senate.
In this latest battle, gay rights advocates are counting on Governor Cuomo and Mayor Bloomberg to get the job done. But traditional marriage supporters say they have a multi-ethnic network of churches and the people they represent.
It'll recontextualize and reboot culture. Healthcare will change. They'll force the gay curriculum will come into the schools in a greater measure.
Bishop Joseph Matera leads Brooklyn's Resurrection Church and the political advocacy group Christ Covenant Coalition. He says networks of clergy around the state are banding together to combat this year's push for gay marriage. Their focus, a small group of undecided state senators.
If we would just keep the senators that voted for traditional marriage, who voted against same-sex marriage a year and a half ago, then we'll be okay.
With just days left till the end of this legislative session, both sides are stepping up the pressure.
We think that the battle has to be won this time by phone calls and emails.
In the fight for gay marriage, advocates say New York would be the biggest prize so far and help lock up the Northeast. It is already legal in Massachusetts, Connecticut, Vermont, and Washington, D.C. Heather Sells, CBN News.
The last day of New York's legislative session is Monday, June 20th, just a week and a half away. The mammoth Arizona wildfire is forcing more people from their homes. Tuesday afternoon, about 2,000 residents from the town of Eager evacuated as the fire threatened to top the ridges surrounding their community. Several other towns already have been evacuated. Fueled by 60-mile-an-hour winds, the wildfire has grown to more than 300,000 acres. That's about twice the size of Chicago. It has already consumed about 500 square miles of pine forest and 10 structures. No lives have been lost. So far, firefighters have been unable to contain the blaze. Parts of the East Coast and Midwest are on alert today for unseasonably hot weather, and some areas could see historic highs. Temperatures climbed to the 100-degree mark and more in Minneapolis Tuesday and set a 23-year high. That severe Minneapolis heat is now headed for the New England area, and summer doesn't officially begin until June 21st, about 2 weeks away.
It's so hot that the devil stopped me and asked me for a ride. It's just that hot.
For some, laughter is the only break from the unseasonable heat wave that has Philadelphia's schools shutting down early so students can beat the scorching heat.
Tomorrow sounds like it's going to be a killer.
The heat is killing roads in the Midwest, where streets are buckling from Minnesota to Mississippi.
It's usually on a joint where two pieces have come together. Usually is where it happens.
Forecasters predict this heat emergency could last for days, and as temperatures climb above 100 degrees...
It's an $89 service fee.
So do the number of calls to Minnesota air conditioner repair shops.
We can't answer the phones fast enough as the way it goes right now.
It hasn't been this hot in Chicago in 5 years, and it's a 1-2 punch in Sioux City, Iowa, where residents are still dealing with floods and now the heat.
It makes it really hard because we're out here all the time sandbagging.
Today's warm weather watches, alerts, and advisories are posted across the Northeast and parts of the Midwest. A Virginia school system will repost copies of the Ten Commandments in its schools. Giles County Schools removed the displays back in December after the ACLU threatened legal action. The group says they violate separation of church and state. But the Giles County School Board members voted 3-2 to put the commandments back up. The ACLU says they will move forward with plans to file a lawsuit. Bishop Eddie Long is starting a satellite church despite the recent sex scandal plaguing his ministry. He says New Birth Birmingham will become the latest branch of his church. The Christian Post reports Long asked members of his Atlanta church to donate between $500 and $1,000 each for the new Alabama church. The Atlanta congregation is having to cut its staff as membership declines. The church blames the cuts on economy and not the scandal. A sexual misconduct suit brought against Long by four young men was recently settled out of court. Conservative and urban church leaders have come together to form a new communion of 1,000 churches strong. Paul Strand shows us how they plan to be fiercely evangelistic, politically relevant, and form congregations of great influence in the world.
Urban church members tend to vote Democrat, even if some of their leaders don't see it being in the best interest of their communities. These leaders believe their new group, the International Communion of Evangelical Churches, or ICEC, can realign urban believers and spark economic, even spiritual revival.
Urban America, there's a blight on the land. We've got generations of young people that have family breakdown. We have all kind of issues of poverty in the land. And the gospel in foreign nations always brings an economic lift, moral standards. And so we believe America may be on the verge of another great awakening.
Where liberal groups like the National Council of Churches have tended to dominate mainline urban denominations, this communion hopes to educate Christians in the power of conservative values. Reverend Aubrey Shines has studied what happens when congregations go into voting booths with more education about candidates and issues.
What we found to be interesting was that the more information they had, the more conservative in their views they became.
I remember the first time I ever voted for president was I voted for Ronald Reagan. And I remember my father calling me Reagan's boy and Uncle Tom and even in my own family. But it took almost to the death of my father, he became conservative at the end. He understood the principles that he taught me was always conservative principles.
This communion will speak out on political issues, but puts evangelism first.
We're a combined communion of about 1,000 churches already. We'll start more, we'll assimilate more. So our combined efforts with crusades in the nations, with teaching members of our churches to evangelize, not just be a secretary, not just be a lawyer, but wherever you are, you're salt and light to bring people to Jesus.
Paul Strand, CBN News, Washington.
President Obama's health care law is back in court today. 26 states are represented in the case against the law. The administration is appealing a Florida court's ruling that found vast portions of the bill to be unconstitutional. A three-judge panel of the 11th U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals in Atlanta is hearing the case. Analysts expect an appeal to the Supreme Court, no matter which side wins. Federal Reserve Chairman Ben Bernanke says Washington urgently needs to take care of its massive debt so the U.S. economy can be healthy in the future. Bernanke also says the current economic recovery is weak, but he expects it to keep going without any serious outbreak of inflation.
Overall, the economic recovery appears to be continuing at a moderate pace, albeit at a rate that is both uneven across sectors and frustratingly slow from the perspective of millions of unemployed and underemployed workers.
Still to come, the biggest terrorist threat to the U.S., what country we need to watch out for most.
Have you ever had an idea for an invention or new product? Bill Schaefer, one of the inventors of Wham-O's new Splash Wash, did. He came up with the idea while watching his children play one hot summer afternoon. Bill invented a car wash for kids. Ride through it, run through it. And Ben helped submitted the Splash Wash to Wham-O, the makers of childhood favorites like the Frisbee, Hula Hoop, and Slip and Slide. If you have an invention you would like to try to patent and submit to corporations and want free information that explains how InventHelp may be able to assist you, call now. InventHelp is America's largest invention company with sales offices in over 50 cities nationwide. Call InventHelp today for free information. Bill Schaefer made a financial gain on the Splash Wash. However, most inventions are not successful, and Bill's experience is not typical of what inventors can expect.
For your free inventor's information, call 1-800-260-7793. That's 1-800-260-7793.
I've fallen and I can't get up. I need help.
When you are home alone and have a bad fall where you cannot move, you are stuck in a very limited area. If you cannot reach a phone, you may lay helpless on the floor for hours or days, which can result in permanent incapacitation or death.
This waterproof pennant is my magic wand. To some of the paramedics, fire department, police, or my doctor, it contacts Life Alert.
When you have a heart attack like I did, and there's no one there, Life Alert was there for me. I couldn't handle the alternative of going to a nursing home.
Thanks to Life Alert, you can live alone without ever being alone. And that's why I wear one.
New Life Alert Classic for seniors or Life Alert 50 Plus.
Please call 1-800-586-0025 for a free brochure about Life Alert. That's 1-800-586-0025. Call us toll free now at 1-800-586-0025. That number again, 1-800-586-0025.
President Obama says this will be, quote, the summer of transition for the U.S. in Afghanistan. The president plans to begin withdrawing troops in the next few months. He says it is time for the Afghans to be responsible for their own security. But both General David Petraeus and outgoing Defense Secretary Robert Gates are urging caution. The U.S. has roughly 100,000 troops in Afghanistan right now. The biggest terrorist threat to the United States may not come from Afghanistan or even Iran, but instead from the country of Yemen. As far back as 2009, CBN News reported Yemen was dangerously unstable and a safe haven for al-Qaeda. Eric Stackelbeck has this look at what's happening in Yemen and how it could affect America.
Al-Qaeda is on the move in Yemen. The terror group violently seized the town of Zinjibar in southern Yemen late last month, declaring it the capital of its Islamic emirate, and Zinjibar might only be the beginning. Embattled Yemeni President Ali Abdullah Saleh fled to Saudi Arabia for medical treatment after being seriously wounded in a rocket attack on his compound last week. It's unclear whether he will return to Yemen. He left behind a nation on the brink of anarchy as as warring tribes and Islamic jihadists seek to take advantage of the growing chaos.
When you look at the indicators throughout Yemen, they're all pointing in the wrong direction. It's a country that's running out of oil. It's running out of water. Sana'a is projected to be the first waterless capital in the world before the end of this coming decade. You have high rates of unemployment.
Then there is Yemen's al-Qaeda problem. Spearheaded by American-born cleric Anwar al-Awlaki, al-Qaeda's Yemen branch has had a hand in several recent attacks on U.S. soil, including the Fort Hood massacre, the attempted Christmas Day underwear bombing, and a plot to blow up cargo planes bound for the U.S.
That was Eric Stackelback reporting. U.S. officials fear that as Yemen descends into further unrest, al-Qaeda fighters there will be much tougher to track as they continue to make their plans to strike America. I want to turn now to the deadly E. coli outbreak in Europe. The number of people reported sick is still rising. Another person died today from E. coli infection, raising the death toll now to 24. And the number of new cases is up by more than 300 from yesterday. Despite these numbers, German officials say there is hope the epidemic is actually declining. That's because there is often a lag in reporting time when the initial outbreak strikes. Coffee prices are on the rise. This is because of less supply of coffee beans and more of a demand from developing countries. But coffee lovers say the high prices will not stop them from getting their fix.
I like Folgers, so I buy it regardless of the price, but the price is a little high.
Usually I wait till coffee goes on sale.
I'm not going to give up coffee. I may drink less.
I'm not giving up, not drinking less either. Starbucks is the latest chain to announce a price increase. The cost of a bag of coffee beans will increase by 17%. Last month, the price of a bag of Folgers and Dunkin' Donuts coffee increased by 11%. The shortage of coffee beans is being blamed on bad weather in coffee-growing regions. Up next, forgiveness. Why it's not only good for your spiritual health, but your physical health as well.
What makes the miracles of Jesus even more miraculous? Standing where they happened, in Israel. Come explore Jerusalem, where Jesus opened blind eyes. Visit the hills of Galilee, where Jesus fed the multitude. Stroll through Capernaum, where Jesus lived and taught and healed. To learn more about standing where it all happened, in Israel, visit www.goisrael.com. Come visit Israel.
Are you anxious to protect your family with life insurance, but afraid you can't afford it? Well, look how much insurance many people can get through SelectQuote for less than a dollar a day. SelectQuote found Rich, 37, a $500,000 policy for under $18 a month. Even though Dave, 43, takes meds to control his blood pressure, SelectQuote got him a $500,000 policy for under $28 a month. Ellen, 47, got a $250,000 policy for under $20 a month. All it takes is a phone call. Your personal SelectQuote agent will answer all your questions and impartially shop the highly rated term life companies SelectQuote represents for your best rates. Give your family the security it needs at a price you can afford. Call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote, we shop, you save.
What makes the miracles of Jesus even more miraculous? Standing where they happened, in Israel. Come visit Capernaum, where Jesus restored a paralytic's helpless legs. Sail the Sea of Galilee, where Jesus walked on the water. Stroll through the Garden of Gethsemane, where Jesus healed a servant's ear. To learn more about standing where it all happened, in Israel, visit www.goisrael.com. Come visit Israel.
A Jewish human rights organization says it has a letter believed to have been written by Hitler, known as the Gemlich Letter. Its contents are thought to be Hitler's first written comments calling Jews a threat that should be removed. It was reportedly found by an American soldier in the final months of World War II. The Simon Wiesenthal Center acquired the letter, calling it one of the most important documents in the history of the Third Reich. Leaders of the center say it shows just how early Hitler became obsessed with killing the Jews. Here's a story you don't hear every day. A Florida homeowner foreclosed on a bank. 5 months ago, a North Carolina-based Bank of America filed foreclosure papers on a couple that had already paid for their home in full with cash. WFMY News reports they never even had a mortgage payment. After a court hearing, the Bank of America was ordered to pay the couple's legal fees, but the money never came in. So the couple's attorney moved to seize the bank's assets with the help of sheriff's deputies. After being locked down for about an hour, the bank manager finally wrote the check for that couple's legal fees. Well, now to the topic of unforgiveness. It is destructive to your spiritual health, and researchers are finding more and more it can destroy your physical health as well. As Lori Johnson shows us, some doctors are now using forgiveness therapy to help treat cancer.
Jane Valseca might not be here today if she hadn't learned to forgive. When she and her husband Eduardo were in Mexico, he was kidnapped and tortured while Jane negotiated his release. She describes the ordeal in her book, We Have Your Husband.
And I knew that the stress could be taking a huge toll on my immune system.
After 8 months, Eduardo was released, but now Jane had to fight for her life.
I was almost not surprised, yet still completely devastated to hear the words, you have stage 4 breast cancer.
Jane prayed for healing, even though doctors gave her a death sentence.
I did collect more information, and in one of the books that I read about Cancer Treatment Centers of America. I thought, wow, this sounds like a fantastic place.
Jane added forgiveness therapy to her cancer treatment with Dr. Michael Berry, a pastor and author of the book The Forgiveness Project.
Harboring these negative emotions, this anger and hatred, creates a state of chronic anxiety. Chronic anxiety very predictably produces adrenaline and cortisol, which deplete the production of natural killer cells, which is your body's foot soldier in the fight against cancer.
Dr. Berry's research on cancer patients showed 61% had forgiveness issues, and more than half of those were severe, like Jane's. She was consumed with revenge against her husband's kidnappers. Forgiveness therapy begins with putting to rest three myths. Forgiveness is not the same thing as reconciliation. It doesn't condone the bad behavior, and it does not stop the pursuit of justice. Jane's path to forgiveness included writing a letter to her enemies, praying for them, and amazingly, finding empathy for them.
I saw the kidnappers as babies, and I took them one by one forward in time in an imaginary scenario that I had created, going through things that I thought that they could probably have gone through in order to get to where they got to do the things that they do and to do what they did to me and to my family. And it was then that I immediately felt this huge sense of relief. It was as if this huge ton of bricks, this weight of the world, was instantly lifted from my shoulders.
When a person forgives from the heart, which of course is the gold standard that we use in Matthew 18, forgiveness from the heart, we find that they're able to find a sense of peacefulness. Quite often our patients refer to that as a feeling of lightness. Lori, we don't realize what a burden anger and hatred is until we let it go.
In medical literature, unforgiveness is classified as a disease, which is defined as some process that overwhelms normal function. Cancer surgeon Dr. Steven Sandifer puts it this way, unforgiveness makes people sick and keeps them sick.
It's important to treat emotional wounds or disorders because they really can hinder someone's reactions to the treatments, even someone's willingness to pursue treatment.
In case you're wondering about Eduardo, well, he's always had a positive outlook.
I love life, I love my family, I love food, I love everything. So I really don't have time to think about these criminals too much. I don't want to take my time, whatever I have left to be in this beautiful planet, to think about negativity.
Eduardo, Jane, and Dr. Barry shared a stage with President Obama recently. They were honored at the Hispanic prayer breakfast for their living testimony of the power of forgiveness.
Millions of women worldwide love Bare Minerals.
This is smooth, it's nice, and it covers. I like that.
Only Bare Minerals looks like beautiful bare skin, while it covers whatever you want it to. And now you can get our latest kit with our totally new, totally spill-proof Click Lock Go Foundation. For over 75% off retail, our new kit comes with Bare Minerals Foundation in the shade that's just right for you. Warmth for a healthy glow. Mineral Veil, the ultimate finishing touch. And Bare Minerals Flawless Application Brush. Call now and get three full-size gifts worth $57.95 free. Purchased separately, you'd spend over $120. Our original Get Started Kit was a great deal at two payments of $29.99. But now you can get all this for just one payment of $29.99. Save over $90 and get a 30-day money-back guarantee.
Call 1-800-376-4174. Ask how you can receive this handy compact. Call 1-800-376-4174 now.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare, call now for a new pain-free meter. These new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Call now, and Arriva Medical will send you one of these new meters for free. And if you have Medicare, your testing supplies may also be covered. Arriva makes it simple. They bill Medicare directly. There are no upfront costs. And they deliver your supplies right to your door for free. With these new meters, there's no coding. You don't have to prick your fingers. And some of these meters even talk.
Your blood glucose reading is 122.
And if you call 1-800-284-9762, we will send you a free Betty Crocker Diabetes Cookbook filled with delicious recipes.
Call Arriva today. You'd be glad you did.
A new hair craze could spell trouble for fishermen, and it has bait shops scurrying to keep their shelves stocked.
What we use them for, to create fish-like, bait fish-type patterns.
These are kind of slim pickings as we have them now, so we're waiting on orders to come in.
Believe it or not, feathers are the newest hair trend hitting the streets this summer. What used to be used as fish bait is now a popular accessory for hair. Salons weave the colorful feathers into young girls' hair, but the demand has caused a shortage of supply for fishermen, especially those in Florida.
It's to be noticed. It's to have fun. And that's what it does in the water. Now human beings are wearing it.
We had a lady come in, and she purchased a little over $100 in just feathers. For hair extensions.
And the reason is we didn't jump on it weeks and weeks ago is we're socially conscious. We wanted to make sure that our suppliers are not doing anything inhumane.
Salon owners say Steven Tyler started the fad when he wore them on American Idol. Each tassel will cost you about $6. Reeling them in. That is going to do it for this edition of CBN News Midday. You can find information on all the stories you've seen here at CBNNews.com. Also, stay up to date with us here at CBN News through Facebook and Twitter. Hope you join us again next time. Have a wonderful Wednesday.
Are you anxious to protect your family with life insurance, but afraid you can't afford it? Well, look how much insurance many people can get through SelectQuote for less than a dollar a day. SelectQuote found Rich, 37, a $500,000 policy for under $18 a month. Even though Dave, 43, takes meds to control his blood pressure, SelectQuote got him a $500,000 policy for under $28 a month. Ellen, 47, got a $250,000 policy for under $20 a month. All it takes is a phone call. Your personal SelectQuote agent will answer all your questions and impartially shop the highly rated term life companies SelectQuote represents for your best rates. Give your family the security it needs at a price you can afford. Call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote, we shop, you save.
Life can be tough. There are challenges for all of us. Jesus told us to pray for one another, and that's exactly what we want to do. On 700 Club Interactive, we use technology to bring Christians together to pray for each other. Meet others just like you and talk or share with them in real time. Watch God work miracles in people's lives. Be part of 700 Club Interactive, weekdays at 11 a.m. on CBN.com.